In the early days, Sonic Youth and us were good friends, and we toured around together, and that was a happy association. But as soon as this whole sort of so-called noise scene and alternative music started building up, it just seemed to me like another form of conformity, and I didn't really want anything to do with it. I have no real sympathy or enmity for the alternative music scene in America. I just don't care about it. I just think it's, you know, there's some good music that comes out of there. I think there's this group that's actually been around for a while, but they're sort of associated with that scene, American Music Club. I just was listening to them the other day. I think they're really good. But they seem kind of separate from the... But anyway, it just seems like a sort of a temporary rebellion before people go on to become consumers. I just look at the Earth as one kind of roiling mass of organisms and molecules and the universe, really. And so I was just thinking about everything kind of eating and breeding and dying and regurgitating and copulating and just everything kind of intertwined in this gooey mass of organisms.
If mercy were to hold me closely, then hide me in her place of no pain, the angels would throw down the water they cried from 100 million eyes. I have a feeling that's growing somewhere behind my sleeping mind. Yeah.
Well, you see this chipped tooth, that's from slamming a microphone into my tooth and
yeah.
Broke a rib, things like that. I guess it's kind of idiotic. But it's like just the physical volume of the music used to just kind of throw me around on the stage. Didn't really have much control. It's like a wind machine throwing about against the wall. You know. That just became, again, I say this, like it could potentially be a self-parody. So it reached a point where I guess we were playing in Berlin, I think, one time. And I had the mic jammed down my throat, and I was essentially just screaming my intestines out, you know.
Lockjaw.
And, you know, throwing my body around. I guess I was naked. And I just kind of looked out at the audience, and they looked pretty bovine, I guess is the word. And it just seemed totally ridiculous to be doing that. And ever since then, I sort of started changing the physical approach anyway.
Yeah.
And now, I really just want to deliver the music with as much dignity as I can scrape together.
So cold, you turned away on your side. Does my timing not flow? Our spectrum so dry. Yet there's still this appeal that we've kept you alive. Love, love will tear us apart again. Oh, love. Love will tear us apart again.
Necessarily changed, because if we had continued the way we were, I think we would have been total fools publicly, and I don't want to be a public fool, so I want to continue to challenge myself and just keep on unfamiliar ground. Love of life is a kind of axiom from Darwinism about, you know, kill or be killed. It's kind of, so it's a little different than what you might think on the face of it. Videotape, just the other night, of Led Zeppelin, for instance, in the early days, and there was no real histrionics in the early, you know, they sort of stood there and played, and that was really kind of effective, I think. I don't think you need to be a dancing doll to affect people with music. You know, really stupidly, I have I can move my fingers around on the guitar and I get tones going that way and some few chords, and then I think of the music building it up by in terms of how you might build up a little film, you know, not really by I don't think of it in a way that a real musician might, or someone who knows how to write music and like that. I think Jarbo thinks more that way.
Everything humans necessarily.